I just realized the crew that comes out with MDZY in that has Snake, and then LSD's our Aurora, and then Quindalyn comes out with them, a Bowser, and then I'm, like, the Bowser here. It's crazy. LSD hates it. But we are starting out game one here on PS2, MDZY versus Nave, Snake versus ZSS. This is an interesting matchup.
Oh,
matchup
wow.
I'd like to... Oh my God.
Nave is doing, like, acrobatics.
Damn.
He's not dead.
Still, that was insanity.
And literally, he's like any given point on the screen, Snake can basically recover.
Holy shit! Oh, he
did
tried
he get
the footstool. He tried. I saw.
No,
it.
I think he went for the stick, and he might have actually gotten it.
I can't tell.
It did not make a noise.
I can't tell. You would have heard, you know, Snake say there. He didn't. He didn't stick him. I'm looking at it.
It looked like he tried.
Nave taking such a commanding, aggressive lead here. Insane.
Oh, he's still by that forward air, though.
Yeah, that forward air is ruthless.
Well, I really like that.
Every time he does that,
that quick falling reverse bear from MVZY. Yeah, he's fine. No! Thank you, God.
Jesus.
I was so scared. I was so afraid that was it. He got like headbocked so hard.
Oh, did you see that fakey? Oh, no double grab for Snake. Oh
okay,
my God.
What I want to see from Nave is that was exactly what I was gonna say.
Wow.
Was as he's upbeing, you clip him with that uppy, get him down to that platform, force him into a tech situation. Reloading the trank, very smart.
Waste that shield. You'll sleep tight, Nave.
Sleep tight, Bummer Nave.
Jesus.
Nave fell asleep, dude.
He didn't give a damn. Ooh, nice. Dodging one of the trains. How many are in the gun? Two?
Four.
Four? Really?
I believe
wow.
It is four, yes. And you can't, no matter how many are in the gun, you can manually reload by double pressing. Oh, and he's got the stick. Nave's gotta watch himself now. He's gotta be. Oh no.
Ooh.
He's not dead. But MVZY is taking the opportunity to manually.
Oh, God.
Yeah, MVZY is doing a really smart move by constantly making sure that his trank is fully loaded. Rather than go and put Nave into a potential edgeguard situation, he decided instead to make sure that his tranks are full. Which I mean, that's, you know, that's a trade-off, because your tranks are full, and that's, you know, they'll be good in the... Oh, wow, that... Yeah, he side-beat right into the mine. Shoutouts to Port 4. Jab his ass right into it. Yeah, I imagine that this is... Oh,
there,
another stick. Oh, he tried to go for it again. That would have been so sick. If he had just detonated it right into another stick. Oh yeah, I like right there. Like, the Snake was directly above ZSS, and Nave went for a double jump up air. But if he had upbeat, it would have negated the.
Oh,
he went
wow.
for a reverse F air. Okay.
No,
in 3.6. Sleep state does not last as long as it did in 3.5, so you don't actually have much of an opportunity to
stick
get someone.
In there, you gotta get in there and do it.
Oh, that was pretty sick.
That
was up,
that was
uppy up air. Why can't LSD do that with his Snake? That makes me so mad. Snake's uppy is so goddamn sick, and LSD, like, he never uses the up B outside of recovering, and it's so sick when you do.
Oh shit.
Yeah, good shit from Nave. Like, that's exactly what I'm talking about. I think in this matchup, he should really be... Right there, that was a good move, because he pulled a grenade. But when he's just when he's just letting that up B rip, get beneath him and hit him with the down B, up B. Maybe he does get the meteor cancel and DIs it wrong and he dies. But either way, he's not in a good situation afterwards. And good.
That's about the third or fourth time he's taken out a mine like that. He's doing really well.
Oh my god, the setup. And he's gone. And I kind of want to go up there and tell him like what. Why just? Oh no!
Oh shit. Who's got it though?
Take him out! He can't run if you break his legs. Uh-oh. I don't like this. What are those walk-offs?
I'm not fond of those. Is that a walk-off on the right? It's banned.
Walk-off on both.
It's banned.
Banana.
Don't fuck him up. Oh,
he fucking tripped on it because of the slope. Oh my fucking god.
And before I miss it, well, I just gets knocked off on the right. Oh shit.
Oh. Oh my god. What's happening? What's happening?
No, you cannot. Okay, I was gonna say Jesus.
There. No, no! Please. You can do this. No, he's still alive. How did he live that? Smash ball! No, get it! Grenade launcher! MGS 5! Yo, we got Green Hill Zone!
No, let's go. Get fucked up, Sonic.
Oh, we got Shadow the Hedgehog as the assist trophy, too. What's Nave doing? Nave is switching up the music? Okay.
Yeah, he didn't give a fuck.
Alright.
Choose your character.
Samus. I like the announcer. Yo, rest in peace, Luigi! Rest in peace.
Luigi!
Gone but never forgotten. MCY taking a really, really close game there in game one. Nave, like I said, I think Nave just now he knows how MCY plays. Now I think Nave is like downloading.
And
it.
Nave gets the counter.
Because look what he did in
Green Hill Zone. Snake gets some pretty good setups here, but that platform, if MVZY misses a tech on that platform, he's screwed.
Oh, he's done.
I mean, when you think about all of ZSS's up moves, moves that go up.
Oh my.
She has quite a few. As you can see there, Nave used 3 different up moves.
There.
Yep. Get that C4 on him. Woo! Oh, smell you later. Damn. Sleep tight, pupper. I think.
Good grab. Oh, that was nice. Oh, I thought he was gonna take the.
I mean, fighting Snake can be pretty tough because you need to balance your aggression with the amount of carefulness. Because you don't want Snake to get his stuff set up. And in order to do so, you have to go in on him. Oh, I think he had to reload his trank there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is... If you're caught reloading your trank, that's like 3 seconds where the opponent can punish you. Oh, thank God he pulled a grenade. Yeah, Snake's so difficult to kill.
Oh God, yeah.
Because if he's holding a grenade and you detonate it, he'll just like survive that until like 250, and then he's difficult to edgeguard. Marth does a pretty bang up job of stopping that.
Oh yeah.
Recovery. Wow, that was a dope ass recovery. Yeah, he's not making that though.
Bop-a-rood anyway. Sleep tight, pupper. Oh my god, these shield hits? Let's go. Ooh, almost gets him with a knife. Oh, good grab. There!
Almost gets him falling off. Right under phase, look at that placement. Perfect.
I think he needs a pause. Oh. Right, it just looks fucking hilarious.
Uh-oh.
I don't know why it just sounds so cool and Snake does it. I just like when he says it.
I think what MVZY is doing is like a mental. I'm not confident that I can edgeguard the ZSS, which is fair because tether characters are pretty difficult to edgeguard. So instead of going for that and potentially missing most of the time, oh he goes too low, and potentially missing most of the time, I'm just gonna reload my strength. And I think. I mean, I might be reading too much into it, but if I'm correct, then it's a very smart move as a player from MVZY.
Oh yeah,
a couple of Dacuses. Shouts to Brawl. I can't deck it. I don't know what that's saying.
Same.
I'm not a PM player. Like, I'll do okay, because, like, I play Melee, and then...
Just transition it to PM.
And occasionally, I'll just access the whack. Is it right on his face again?
Yeah. There.
What a good early PM moment was when I was just playing Snake against, Yeah, it was, I don't remember who it was. It was one of my friends. They were playing, like, Samus or ZSS.
Oh, God, though.
Oh, wow. Good stock. I just put the C4 right on the chest. I just go, ha! Right on the chin.
Right on the...
Party ball!
Man, there
500 KOs.
Let's fucking go.
Huh? Oh my god. What a good moment. We got a pause of the tranquilizer dart going, like, into ZSS's butt. Oh yeah, and I was playing Ness and I baseball batted the trank back at the snake. This is like the first 3 months we played the game. It's fucking stupid. Alright, here we go. It's 1-1.
Game 3, FD. Interesting choice. I don't know, I feel like this pick for FD, I feel like gives just as much free roam to ZSS that it does Snake.
I think ZSS is better here than Snake.
Oh god, chart.
He's not. He's not going.
No, he's nowhere near gone.
You think?
I'm just saying. You think he's still dead? Well done. Implying Snake.
And until
just
that
dies.
Number reaches like 300, he's not in any danger. Unless he doesn't DI back, in which case he's in some danger. It takes a good early first stop. I think Nave's got a better grip on this matchup and this player.
Oh yeah.
MBZY is tranquilizing too much. It's a habit that you see from LSD. It's a habit that you'll see from him. They rely a whole lot on tranks to get their setups. When like I said earlier, against I'd say the heavier half of the cast of this game.
Okay.
At most percents, up B just leads into a stick.
Right.
You just up beat, boom, got him.
Yeah, it's so fast.
On Spacey's, it's unavoidable for a long time. And oh, not good DI in the F-Smash. And Nave's up a full stock. A couple of Dacuses. Oh my god! I don't know what happened. I think Nave's a little bit hesitant to throw out those neutrals. Ooh, that was bad DI on that.
Yeah,
on that back air. That was
I'll take good. What is DI for 800?
Shoutouts to, I think it was Oh, was it Hex versus Thorn? Where
yeah.
and Toph was commentating and he died from a knee on Dreamland at like 50 something. And then Toph just goes, that was the worst DI I've ever seen.
Yeah. What a hilarious.
That wasn't the worst DI I've ever seen. It was just really bad. I have enough talking crap about his DI. What I was saying earlier, I think Nave's a little bit hesitant to throw out the ZSS side Bs in the neutral.
Okay.
Yep, and there it is. Reload the trank. Put down a mine. Pull a grenade. You like how I literally just like knew all seven of the things that he would do in sequence? Like, it's Snake. Like.
Go in that mine. And their champ. Oh, he's moving up with it, and he's gonna whip that mine. Oh, he's getting that.
There you go. It's gone.
Oh. 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 Oh my goodness. Oh.
You're shitting me? He just ate. She just ate it. He just ate paralyzer pistol.
That whip.
Like, it like hit him in like the. Uh-oh. Oh, Nave mashes out of that grab at 14%. Could have been a bad situation for him. Dave's looking for a back air. This is anyone's game still, though. Oh my god.
Oh god. Oh.
Oh, what are you... Oh! Okay.
Come on.
This is close. Tight game! There it is! There it is! Off of the bounce! Woo! Nice work from Nave, game two. But this is 3 out of 5. He's still got one more game to take, and MVZY needs to figure out what to do. I don't think FD was the best counter pick. I'd say Smashville. I think that is.
Yeah, Snake doesn't do too hot on Smashville.
I think that Smashville for Snake against ZSS would be excellent.
With all that free room, especially with that moving platform, it just ZSS is just all.
I think he's thinking the same thing that I am.
That grenade does nothing every time.
I find that.
Oh, just right to the
face. He gave him like a hug. You ever see like?
Damn, Nate go.
Dawn of the Dead.
Yes.
Where it's like. Where it's like the apartments and like where the woman just walks up to her zombified husband and just hugs him and he just bites him. That was that.
That was pretty much it. Shout out to Dawn of the Dead.
Good movie reference.
George Romero's early stuff was pretty solid.
Oh yeah.
His new stuff is fucking terrible. I'm sorry, George Romero.
it's
George Romero, if you're watching this stream, I'm sorry, but your new stuff fucking sucks. Land of the Dead? What a terrible movie.
Turns out George Romero actually watches competitive Smash like every day.
He just watches, he's like, what the fuck, dude? That was my vision. That was my vision. Speaking of bad movies, did you hear M. Night Shyamalan's doing Avatar The Last Airbender 2?
Oh, for Christ's sake.
And like...
No, he wouldn't.
No, he's
He wouldn't desecrate it. Such a fucking relic.
No,
humans.
I mean, he... I don't think it's above him. Yeah, but like I was saying, M. Night Shyamalan was like, dude, like... The first Last Airbender movie, he was talking about, like, I think that was a good movie. Like, I think that was what the movie should have been. And everyone else on Earth's like, are you sure?
Really?
I think it was Watch Mojo's, like, top 10 worst casting choices. Number one was the entire cast of the Avatar The Last Airbender. Just the entire cast. All right, back to the game. I loved Avatar The Airbender so much when I was a kid. And my friends who loved it saw it in theaters like the day after it came out. We were so fucking disappointed. It was so bad. It was so garbage.
Yeah, it's piss.
Like, honestly, like, top 100 worst movies of all time. It's on that list.
Oh, yeah.
One more. Okay, good spot dodge.
Nate says no.
Oh, this is dead even.
Oh.
Not anymore. Smell you later, Snocky.
Snocky.
Did he taunt? Did I miss that? Did he just taunt and then like
I heard this at all.
Barely avoid the crank?
I think he
really? Oh, he died from the oven. They pointed at the screen like, I didn't think I would die from that.
I didn't think he died from that at all.
He's doing what I said he should do.
I saw it, the whip.
Let's
go,
Knave. Please do it. Please do it. Yes, he's doing it! He's doing the thing I said he should do! I'm so happy! Oh my god, that setup was pretty brutal. Just manages to avoid his own mine. Uh-oh. That wasn't safe.
Oh,
he goes in deep.
Oh.
He goes in deep again.
He wants it. Oh,
but he's gone.
Gets punished for it.
MVZY is on his last stock. Is probably on his last stock. I mean, we'll see, but...
Oh.
That was strange. Okay.
Yeah, that was weird. Oh, okay. Good little conversion here coming from Knave. He's gonna want to do stuff like that. Just grab and, you know, up air.
Uh-oh.
Simple 20 rounds. Did he get hit?
He's stuck. He gets knocked up. He's gone. All right, tight battle. Trank's fully loaded. Doesn't have a mine down. But he's firing off the... Yeah, this is actually, like, what you should do when your opponent's dead and you have a chance. Reload your Trank. Stand on that moving platform, start firing up smashes. There go. Whoa, he's just walking. This is anyone's game.
Oh.
Oh! He got him! He got
Did
the
he?
Stick.
Oh, shit.
He's. Alright. Sorry about the, like, trumpet
it
noise.
Is absolutely
dude.
Even. Or was.
The, like, angry dude!
You're like, burr!
I thought he had like way more percent than he actually had for some reason. I thought he was at like 100, but he was actually at like 60 something. This is such a tight battle right now.
Oh my god, this can be anyone's game.
There's a mine over there. Both players should be aware of that on the left. Oh my god, shield
grab.
Oh no. Oh my god, he almost got that. He's doing exactly what I said that he should be doing in this matchup. I'm so happy. Even if he loses, I'll just be
Oh.
I almost crapped my pants. Just hit from Nave, you jerky son of a bitch, and then narrowly misses. He just fired three trinks in a row. There's no fear. Oh my god, this is such a tight battle. No! Fucking Pooch! Oh, happy birthday, Nave. God.
Well, look at Antonio. Look at Antonio's face. God damn it. He's just like, really?
Antonio's like, I would've lost him. That doesn't mean you should. You should have.
Antonio's just that smug. That.
The judgmental.
Yeah.
Like, why did you lose? When in reality, Antonio would have done the ultimate loss.
Got him, dude. I'm gonna say.
Right, Nave gets a counter pick.
Nave is gonna go to. GNC again, maybe?
I think he won last on Green Hill, I believe.
I'm gonna say P.
So this might be. This is.
I don't like Fountain because the mines are so hard to see.
I'm actually with you on that. I think.
I don't like Fountain. That's not a good pick.
I think Nave will win a Pokemon game one, and I think Pokemon is his best choice left here. Because if. I think Green Hill would be his best choice. I don't think he can go. Mm-mm. So I think he's
Pokemon's the next best one.
So I think Pokemon's his next best choice.
Don't go Fountain, Nave. Come on.
I don't think Fountain's
better.
Choice.
You know better. Come on. Don't do that.
It's not that he can't win it on this stage. It's just,
I know, but I just think
we'll see how it goes.
Snake a lot. So game five.
ZSS does have some advantages here in this matchup. He went for like an aerial trank there or whatever. Okay, Nave needs to realize that MVZY is, like, basically in the neutral, he's just tranquilizing. He's just tranking over and over again. I like that reverse bear. I think that was very smart. But MBZY's DI was pretty good there. Good shielding from Nave.
Oh.
He's fine.
That was any other character.
He just dropped.
He tried to fire an aerial trank. Didn't realize he was out of bullets. Fell to his death trying to reload his gun. What a sad story this is.
That was any other character. They'd already be like stocks down from Nave's paralyzed shots.
Woo!
Damn.
Happy birthday, Nave. You're down. You're done.
The Kobe.
What a job. Yeah, dude. This is a little bit scary, even.
Oh,
what?
Oh, that was the weirdest ass grab I've ever seen.
I think that was. Okay. Thank God he capitalized on that. He wasn't quite close enough. Nave, I think, going for a lot of, like, kind of unsafe space back air on shields. Oh, good read! And he almost covered all the options, but he couldn't get there quite quick enough.
Nave definitely knows what's up, though. He had that locked. Like, it was so good.
Wow. Some bear pressure. Uh-oh, look out for the mine. Oh my god, that was... I would have been so scared. Alright, good move. Alright, you ever just watch a match and you just have a premonition?
Yes.
One of these stocks, MVZY is going to put down a mine, and Nave's going to get, like, the meteor of up B, and, like, draw him right down into the mine on the ground, and then kill MVZY with it. That's a premonition, prediction.
That would be the sickest. Oh, no.
Oh, just misses the forward.
He mashed out of that so hard. Dude, if that happens, though, not only are you a fucking
How
god,
did that hit?
I don't even know how that
he
hit.
Was like...
That bolt's obviously a heat seeker. That was a ZSS skull-seeking bullet.
Alright, I mean, this is still pretty tight. This is also game 5. This is pretty crazy. Oh! That setup from MVZY was about a 50% setup. Oh! He's gone.
Oh.
Why did he reload the drink? What are you doing, dude? I mean, if you see he's recovering, you got him stuck. Okay, okay. No. Nave's on his last legs. This is the last stock of the loser semis for him.
Who's cheering on Nave?
All right, don't say let's go Nave, because he doesn't love it.
I'm not gonna.
He's just firing that off.
I'm just gonna be real quiet now. Oh.
Oh my God.
What a conversion.
Oh my God, that is a quick 70.
What a
Nave's
conversion.
In trouble.
That was intense.
There he goes. Nave's in it though. Nave is in it. That mine's gone.
He's just gotta keep his distance. He's gotta stay cool.
Just living. One more of those and he's not living. And that's...
No. He's not out. He's not out yet.
Watch out for the mine, Nave.
Good grab. Oh.
Hold that mine right there!
It's over. He's stuck. This is so scary. Oh my God. Oh!
Is this guy playing?
Why'd he back here? Okay, it's alright. He's not dead yet, though. Don't do it! Don't do it again! It won't work again. It only works that much.
No! Damn it! God!
Oh my god!
Oh my God, what a nail
biter.
Nave goes down to the fucking...
Oh my God.
Nuts ass... I have to hop off the commentary. I have to hop. I'll probably be back in a little bit. I'm gonna hop off for a little bit.
Fuck.
That was, what the fuck? I gotta leave for work Areno. Who wants to take this? So I'm heading out. That was fucking disgusting. Disgusting way to end the night. I'll be here next week. Otherwise than that, you guys have a good night and see you next week.
Yeah, I know. I'm not a 70%.